set, off! Thank you. street, man.
Thank you.
Our brother Ivan has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. We can hear the Lord greet him in the words of sacred scripture. Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call Ivan from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth, for we are all dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies, and make them like his own in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace, and raise him on the last day. Together, let us bind that prayer with the prayer that Jesus taught us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
For us as Christians, this isn't the end. But for Ivan, it's the beginning of a new chapter. And we know that for him, he's with the Lord. And with the Lord, there is no time, there is no space. That we carry him with our heart in our hearts, as we even as we carry the Lord. We know that for Ivan, when he sees the Lord face to face and he turns around, he'll see Jen, he'll see his baby, because it wouldn't be heaven without them. But until that day, we walk by faith, not by sight, trusting that the promises that Jesus gave us of a Father's love and care will never be broken and will be fulfilled at the end of time. Almighty God, through your death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they are true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
And may his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. And we pray.
May the world rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall softly on your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold his hand.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. First Lieutenant Ivan Lechowich, United States Army, made the ultimate sacrifice on September 28, 2011, in service to his country. When a man or woman enters our armed forces, their service banner contains a blue star. It is by fate and sacrifice their blue star turns to gold. The red border of their banner represents the blood given by many warriors in defense of our country, freedom, and human dignity at home and on foreign soil. The field of white stands for the purity of spirit and the price of peace that only a warrior can truly know. The blue star signifies loyalty, honor, and duty. A gold star has now been placed upon Ivan's blue star. A small border of blue outlines the newly placed gold star. It will forever serve as a tribute from those whose star has remained blue to remember Ivan, his courage and sacrifice, and to pay honor to his family and friends and the servicemen and women left behind. Because of this, the gold star not only symbolizes Ivan's supreme sacrifice, but it should also give you a measure of pride and consolation. The honor of being a blue star or gold star parent or spouse is one that only your child or spouse can give you. As part of your military family and the mothers of warriors, we are here to offer our support as you cross the bridge from blue to gold. To all of you that have suffered this loss at the hand of an enemy of the United States of America, we offer our sincere condolences on the loss of your hero, First Lieutenant Ivan Lechowich. On behalf of the Blue Star Mothers of America, Greater Tampa Bay Chapter, with honor and respect, we present to you this gold star banner for your loss and his sacrifice for our country. I leave you all with this. As you gaze upon the beauty of a starry night sky, you will notice one star in particular that shines brighter than all the rest. That will be Ivan's star. He is now nestled among the stars of his fallen brothers and sisters in service, never to be forgotten. His mission now, to watch over and guide the way that the remaining warriors will return safely home.
And God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes, and there shall be no more death. To the Lechowich family, friends, the little hometown soldiers is a group of young people between the ages of 5 and 16 years of age that reaches out to children and families that have loved ones specifically in Iraq and Afghanistan. This afternoon, we appreciate so very, very much you allowing your loved one to serve this great nation. God bless you and God bless America. At this time, they would like to present to the mother with the baby. I'm sorry, I don't know the baby's name.
Natalie.
Natalie. We'd like for you to put this, please, aside for Natalie until she can appreciate it. God bless you very much.
Thank you.
There are many stories and scriptures throughout time that speak of the dove as being a sign of peace and hope and God's eternal love he has for all that he created. When I release this flock of 21 doves today to go along with the military salute, we'd like to think that that represents the friends, the family members, and loved ones. And now we must include Lieutenant Lechowich's military family also that went on before him. As I release these single doves, we like to think that that represents the spirit and the soul of Lieutenant Lechowich going up to be with his families, his friends, and his loved ones, and now his military family. And if you don't mind, I have another single dove that we'd like to release today that will represent the POWs and the MIAs throughout time. I encourage everyone here, if you have a mind to please make a wish and say a little prayer for the family, because as you know from the story of Noah, your wishes and prayers will come true when released on the wings of a dove. The Bible says in Psalms 55:6, oh, that I had wings of a dove, for then I would fly away and be at rest. This bird will represent the spirit and soul of Lieutenant Lechowich. We'll let this one represent all the POWs and MIAs. They'll get back together on their flight home. Jim, I have here for you today on behalf of myself, all the military, and all the people here at the Serenity Gardens.